If you've been in or around Arch Linux past month or so, you probably know there's a bit of a mess going on. So back in July, there was a big malware scare where a bunch of packages were uploaded to the AUR trying to emulate real packages. They got taken down fairly quickly, and then more of them got uploaded. All of that's been cleaned up now, but it was still a big deal. And then more recently, the website, the AUR, and at times the forum are looking a bit like this. There is a wide-scale DDoS attack taking place on Arch Linux infrastructure, and this time it doesn't appear to be an accident caused by Manjaro. If you don't know what I'm talking about, do a search for Manjaro DDoS AUR. Now, looking towards the status page, which luckily is hosted separately and nobody is trying to take the status page down, this is gonna look mostly green. Keep in mind though, that each of these bars represents a day. Starting here though, there's a lot of red. Now it looks like things initially kicked off around August 7th. This was just a very brief outage though, and things kind of just went back to normal. A couple of days later, August 12th, this is when things really kicked off. This is when the full-scale attack actually happened. Now, thankfully, the wiki, whilst it has had some minor outages, it's been mostly fine. So if you want to access the wiki, you're still been good to do so. The most affected are the AUR and the website, which as you saw, literally as of recording this, the website is currently down. If I do a refresh, hey, it's back now. We'll see how long that lasts. Probably not that much longer. As of right now, it is either not known or not disclosed where this is coming from, why this might be happening, who is DDoSing a Linux distro like Arch Linux, right? Like, why are you doing this? I reached out to the Arch Linux team. So far, no one has gotten back to me, so I don't know. There's some reason why it's happening. I've seen plenty of fun ideas floating around about why this might be the case, though. I saw someone saying, and this seems like entirely possible, following that malware incident, the person got very annoyed, and now they're like, you caught my malware. I'm gonna DDoS Arch Linux infrastructure. Is that possible? Absolutely, right? If you're gonna upload malware to the AUR, would you DDoS Arch Linux as well? Probably. I could see someone doing that. More of a meme idea is it being Manjaro again, which obviously is a joke. For anyone who didn't go and look it up before, basically, one of the older versions of the Manjaro GUI package manager, it had a bug where it was constantly pinging the AUR, and that basically caused a DDoS when all of the Manjaro users were all pinging the AUR. Obviously not what's happening here, but it is funny to think about. And something else very possible is it's just some dumb kids who want to annoy people and bait people like me into making videos about being annoyed. On the 14th of August, this post is made to the Arch Linux mailing list. Just in case this archive is down as well, I will post a link to the Wayback Machine archive in the description down below. AUR website down, can't reach aur.archlinux.org. So this person was trying to update some NVIDIA packages, they couldn't download the package, they went to the website wasn't working, they tried to ping the site, and got a 66% packet loss. Is there a known or new issue? So at this point, nothing was officially publicly announced. So people were starting to notice across platforms like Reddit, Discord, various other places, but that's about as much as it was. So a lot of people were assuming, is this maybe some infrastructure migration that was never announced or something like that, something within the realm of normality. Then a few days later, this post was made. Arch Linux services unavailable. As you might be aware, some of our services, AUR, forums, main website, are currently affected by a DDoS attack. We are aware of the issues and are actively working on mitigation efforts. We are working with our data center operator and various network providers, and we are aware of the community offers to help. We appreciate your patience, and we will provide periodic, I assume, updates is missing here, keeping technical detail internal for security reasons. Thanks, the Arch Linux DevOps team. Interestingly though, it wasn't a full takedown of the service. Some people are saying they're able to access it through IPv6, so I'm not a networking guy, but there was that. And more recently, a post was made to the newsfeed. Recent service outages. All of this stuff here is just re-explaining what I already said before. Hey, there's a DDoS. Hey, we're working it out. We're gonna deal with this. All this good stuff. As a volunteer-driven project, we appreciate the community's patience as our DevOps team works to resolve these issues. Please bear with us and thank you for all the support you've shown so far. Again, I don't know why somebody is DDoSing a volunteer-driven project. Like, what are you doing? Genuinely, what level of degeneracy do you get up to that you are DDoSing a volunteer-driven project? What is wrong in your life that this is the thing you feel like doing today? Not just today, for the past couple of weeks. Now, this is the important part for Arch Linux and future Arch Linux users. Workarounds during disruption. And it's not just in this case, any future DDoSes as well. All of this is still going to apply, assuming tools don't go around and change. In the case of downtime for archlinux.org, that being the Arch Linux website, the place where you download the ISO and things like that. For mirrors, the mirror list endpoint used in tools like Reflector is hosted on this site. Please default to the mirrors listed in the Pacman mirror list package during an outage. So Reflector is a tool for basically automatically updating your mirror list based on various criteria that you want it to update on. Whether that be the speed of the mirror, the location of the mirror, how up to date the mirror is. Basically ensuring that you have the best download experience when you're trying to download packages on Arch. Whilst the mirrors themselves are fine, there is not a mirror of the list of mirrors. So if you're using Reflector to pull down the list of mirrors and then sort the list of mirrors based on your various criteria, it has nowhere to automatically pull the mirror list from, so this tool is going to fail. I've seen a lot of people getting very confused who have Reflector automatically running. Yeah, just either don't have it run or cancel out of that part of the update process and you'll be fine. Now, this is not saying that if you're having mirror issues, you can't go and resolve it. The mirror list file is at /etc/pacman.d, and then in here in the mirror list file. So this is still a local file on your system. You can still go and manually edit this. It's just pulling the file in automatically probably isn't going to work right now. If you're unsure how to update your mirror list and what you can actually put in there, check the mirrors page on the Arch Wiki. This is the best place to go. It goes through manually doing it, automatically doing it, how to rank by various different criteria. Really good page. Now, especially from new Linux users, I've seen some confusion about this. You're not downloading packages when you update Arch Linux from the Arch infrastructure. All of these mirrors are hosted in various places around the world, whether it be universities, some club somewhere, an ISP. All of these are hosted all around the globe. Some countries more than others. The US, for example, has a lot of mirrors. Australia has a couple, and some countries out there might have one or zero. All of these still, okay, most of these still work. Maybe some of them are being taken down through various other means, but these are not on the Arch Linux infrastructure, and these are not being affected by the DDoS. This is one of the nice things about how Linux works, not just Arch Linux, but most distros out there. They have a bunch of mirrors all around the globe, and if one of them goes down, the others are going to keep working. And the same can be said about the ISO. Our installation image is available on a lot of mirrors. For example, the DevOps administered Geo mirrors. So this is something actually, okay, don't go to it on the web archive, whatever, it worked. This is something run by the Arch Linux team. However, if you can get to the Arch website, if we go to the download page here, don't be broken. Okay, we go. There is also a big list of other mirrors down here as well. A lot of the same places that are running like package download mirrors as well also are running mirrors of the Arch Linux ISO. This is probably the best way to go and download it. There is another option, and that being the BitTorrent link here. My main issue with the BitTorrent link isn't the BitTorrent link itself, it's how people treat the BitTorrent link. Towards the end of the month, it has been leached to death, and you will not download anything from this. I wish more people that use this went and seeded. I might just have to do so myself, because this barely ever works. And of course, if you download the ISO, make sure you go and verify its integrity. Now, let's be serious here. How many times that you've downloaded an Arch ISO or Ubuntu ISO or any other distro ISO and verified its integrity? Because I know that it's something we all know we should do, but I also know that barely anyone does so. I see it more done by people who are downloading Linux for the first time, doing YouTube videos, things like that, because it's part of the instruction set. If you're familiar with Linux, people kind of just skip over those instructions. In the case of the AUR, you are not out of luck because there's actually an official mirror available on GitHub. Let's go to the actual link, not the archive. And you'll notice the repo looks very, very empty. That's because of the way the AUR works. So each of the packages are actually their own separate branch here. There is a lot of things in the AUR, so there's a lot of packages. And honestly, this got me thinking. I don't know why any of the AUR managers, things like Peru and stuff like that, in the case of the AUR website not working, don't have a fallback path to this. If you're a developer on any of those projects, and there's a reason why that wouldn't be possible, I'd love to know. But if that is something that could be done relatively easily, I don't see why having that as a fallback path shouldn't be done. Now, the git command to obtain the package is a little bit different because on the AUR website, you are downloading individual repos. On the GitHub mirror, you are downloading a branch from a mega repo. But once you actually have that repo, all you need to do is follow the manual instructions on the AUR wiki page, and you'll basically be good to go. Pretty much just a matter of running make package and yeah, it's not much more than that. The first time you ever installed an AUR package, when you installed your AUR helper, the same instructions as that. But you probably forgot how to do that because you installed your AUR helper and then never manually installed anything else again. The wiki is currently down right now, isn't it? I was gonna say, the wiki has had very minor outages. If I refresh, is it gonna work? Yes, but it might be loading the cache. Okay, anyway, if when you're seeing this, the wiki is down as well, there are packages to download clones of the wiki. ArchWiki Docs and ArchWiki Lite contain recent snapshots of the articles as hosted by the Arch Linux wiki. If the wiki is down, check that out. Otherwise, yes, the wiki is really good and the wiki is amazing, but you will generally find the information other places as well if you kind of know what to look for. And the wiki is entirely red now. If you don't want to stare at this page constantly, I would highly recommend you go and check out the Arch Linux subreddit. News posts, people are always going to be talking about stuff here. You're going to find out when things are kind of dealt with. But do check back on this and just sort of see the state of things. Throughout the course of this video, it's gotten worse. The website operational again. Hey, it got slightly better. See how long that one lasts. We'll see how long that lasts. I don't expect it to be much longer. Whilst this issue is definitely a big issue, it's not going to go on forever. They will resolve it. The people doing the DDoS will get bored. The Arch Linux team will move behind a Cloudflare proxy or something else like that. And this is going to get fixed. When that's going to happen, we'll see. Will it be tomorrow? Will it be just after I finish recording? Probably not that. Will it be next week? We'll have to wait and see. The one good thing about it happening now is we're not well into holiday season, right? We're not in December where a lot of people are taking time off for Christmas and New Year's and other holidays that happen around that time. So people are around to fix it. And best of luck to the Arch Linux team. Hi there, I have briefly returned. It is 10:40 p.m. right now. I was winding down to do some other stuff and somebody mentioned something that happened in my Discord that is very relevant here. So, about a week ago, this person going by the name Drop Security started posting things like this. Pingserverarchlinux.org, posting links to the Arch website, and other things like the status page for some sort of other system. they seem to have been taking claim, taking responsibility for the DDoSing of Arch Linux. I don't know if this is real. I don't know if this is bait. They are already long gone from Discord. But it still felt worth mentioning. And then from there, just began spamming a link to their website. Again, I don't know if this is real, but either way, this did happen. Let me know down below if you have a theory. Do you have a theory on why this might be happening? Do you have a theory on where this might be coming from? Even the craziest crackpot theory, I want to hear them. So, let me know down below. If you like the video, go like the video. If you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out my Patreon, Scrub, Silly Burrow Pay, link in the description down below. That's going to be it for me. And what if I told you that I was the villain all along? What is this?